Hi everybody, hope you're all having a wonderful day. It's a very rainy day in Sydney today. We need the rain. As you know, that we had a lot of bushfire damage end of last year and also beginning of this year. So we need the rain. Anyway, if you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Walter, I'm from Sydney, Australia. And today I would like to try the authentic Sri Lankan street food. And I'm at the Glebe Point Road in Glebe. So come on, let's join me. So stay tuned till the end of the video and I will be showing you my awesome, my wonderful experience at the Dish Sri Lankan street food restaurant in Glebe, Sydney. And I will be interviewing the owner of the restaurant, Manjula, and also wonderful hospitality by the staff members, and my food experience, delicious food I will be eating in the dish restaurant, street food restaurant, Sri Lankan street food restaurant. So please stay tuned. So my menu has arrived. Plenty of options, let's see. So I'm kind of thinking of a special lunch menu. They got the platter of fish roll with dip sauce, one egg hopper, chicken kottu, and choice of meat curry and string hopper and dal. So let's see. Also, one thing I've noticed that the staffs are very friendly and very accommodating as well. I took the permission to video and they're quite happy with that. And they gave me extra room by myself just so I can vlog it properly, not too noisy. So yeah, so thumbs up for the first impression. Well done. Sri Lankan street food restaurant. So I'm ready to order. What do you think about the special lunch set menu?
Yeah, special lunch set menu. We give like this one is giving all food in one plate.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So we giving one egg hopper.
Yeah, yeah.
And one fish roll.
Yep.
And chicken kottu.
Okay.
And give some spices like sambals and the curry.
Excellent.
And you can select any curry for that.
Okay. Yeah, so
three
string
hoppers.
Okay, so curry is my choice. So what curries have you got?
We have got lamb, chicken,
okay.
And chicken.
Pork. Okay. Can I get chicken, please?
Chicken?
Yeah, please. Thank you. How long this restaurant been open for?
It's 2.5 years.
2.5 years. Okay. Yeah. When I search on Google, it shows up quite often. Pretty popular, you guys.
Yeah. because of the Sri Lankan.
Sri Lankan, yeah. And the street food as well.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's an authentic street food, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. I looked it up on Google and then it comes up that this so one and the Kottu. Kottu and the
famous in the Sri Lanka.
Yeah.
Yeah. Most of that in like hoppers.
Yeah. The hoppers is pretty popular as well. Yeah. Alright, so let's go with that one.
And
the drink. Can I get the mango?
Polish?
Yeah, please. Yeah. So you think that's all in a one? So
yeah,
it tastes everything in one plate.
Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you very much. And thank you for giving me this area. And I'm vlogging, so yeah. And you can have a look at the YouTube later on. Thank you. So I ordered the, they have the set menu for the lunch, special menu. And it's basically varieties of combinations of Sri Lankan street food. You can get it in one, which is suitable. And yeah, so let's wait for the food. Can't wait to try the first Sri Lankan street food experience. It is such a great opportunity to see when the chefs are cooking for my lunch. It's not a coffin quite an often you say. That's the Kottu roti, yay!
Did you mix it well?
Yeah. What an awesome experience. Excellent. So that's my chicken kottu almost ready, so very excited. Can't wait to try. It is quite an experience. We barely get to see when the chefs are preparing your food. Thank you, chef.
Thank you. This is egg
kottu. Yep.
And chicken kottu, fish roll, and this is chicken kottu, coming with chicken curry, dal, and this is pork sambal, chili sambal, kak sambal, and this is...
Wow. Look at how massive is this. Hiran, thank you very much. Shout out to Hiran. Awesome job. Thank you, Hiran. Thank you. Alright, just did the hand sanitizer. So, first time trying the egg hopper. Mmm. Oh wow, very ricey. It's a rice flour, obviously. So the egg hopper is basically it's a pancake based and some rice flour, and the flour with some mild spices and the obviously chicken egg. Awesome. Let's try the egg hopper with some dal. The dal is very creamy. Oh wow. Got a little spice kick to it, but very creamy. I can I can taste this, the spices of turmeric, cumin, a bit of coriander. Mmm. Very delicious. Let's dip in the egg hopper. Bit of a chicken curry. Oh wow. Oh wow, that chicken curry. Whoa. Cool, spices. Very good. Try the fish roll. Mmm. Oh wow. Oh wow. A lot of spices in the fish roll. It looks very basic, but a lot of spices in there. Very delicious. Mmm. Mmm. As you all know that any fried things, I love it. Anything deep fried, I completely love it. And this is one of the food. Mmm. Let's try to dip in the sambar. Try with that sambar. Oh wow. It's got a bit of sweetness. And the mint. Mmm. Chef, what is this? What's the
this one pole sambal.
Pole.
Ah. Yeah, it's made up of coconut.
Okay.
And this one sini sambal.
Okay.
It's onions.
Yep.
And this one kata sambal. Made of tomato, onions, everything.
Yep.
So this is the string uppers.
Yeah, string uppers.
String
uppers.
This one
told me. Dal curry, yeah. Very delicious.
And this one prawn dip. Actually, it's made up of cashew nuts, onion, tomato.
It's really good. I just tried it.
Yeah, that one is really good.
It's really good. Mmm. Now you guys out there don't know how much you guys are missing over here. It's utterly, it's utterly delicious. Mm. Let's get a chicken piece by itself. That chicken, the sauce, I tried it before. Oh man, it's so good. Mmm. Oh man. Mm. I made the right decision to come into the Sri Lankan street food today. Man, you guys are out there. Must come and try this, come and visit. All right, time for a string hopper. First time. And I can tell it's made out of rice as well. Dipping in the chicken curry. Let's try the string hopper by itself. Mm. Just some dal. That is so good. Oh. Sambal. Get some string hopper. Get some dal. Oh. The string hopper is kind of like kind of rice, but it doesn't have the sticky texture of the rice. But it is really good with curry. When you dip it with the curry or dip it with the dal, it's completely different. This is the coconut sambar. Trying coconut sambar by itself. Ah, very coconutty. No idea what's in there, but very delicious. Now the time for the center of the attraction, which is the famous Sri Lankan street food, Kottu roti. First time. Those who don't know what is the Kottu roti is basically the roti bread. What they do is they chop it into very small pieces and they fry it with the different varieties of vegetables, eggs, kind of like a fried noodles, but obviously spices, which makes it authentic Sri Lankan spices that gives a different texture. It's very delicious. Oh my God. I think it has eggs and also fish in it as well. Man, that Kottu roti is completely out of the way. So utterly delicious. I can chew the fish. Crunchy goodiness from the fresh vegetables, chili, coriander, onion rings. Whoa, man. All right, almost nearly there with the egg hopper. I'm gonna use it like a. Oh, look at that. Look at that, eggs coming up. Oh my God. Oh, look at that. Egg is oozing out. Oh my God. That runny egg. So satisfying. And I can eat 10 of this every day.
delicious.
I'm so sad that this is going down. This is the last bite I have at the moment. Oh, so good, the egg hopper. Extremely delicious. Check this out, this nice decoration. Platter is almost empty now. It's the last piece of chicken. Great experience getting the authentic Sri Lankan food for the first time. Highly impressed with the food quality and also the varieties of food in one, and also the lovely, wonderful, friendly staff, friendly chef. And I've got the owner here as well, so soon I'll be sitting down with the owner to talk about his inspiration for this restaurant. I've got the owner of the Sri Lankan street food, Glebe.
Hi.
Manjula. So welcome, Manjula.
Thank you.
So please tell me about yourself. What inspired you to open this restaurant?
Yeah, I was a chef by profession, and I moved to Australia in 2005. So when I came to Australia, I was working in Five
star.
Yep. And I opened
my own business in 2007. Were you the chef of Carrie
Packer? Yeah, I was one of the chefs.
Okay, yeah. Because I looked at the history and yeah.
I was there for 6 years. Then I started in a club, like doing a bistro. And then there only I started Sri Lankan buffet.
Yep, yep.
Which is something new to the city people. Like, yeah. I did an all-night buffet every Saturday, uh-huh, with the band playing, so it was very popular.
Yeah.
And that was actually in a bowling club. So after that, I opened my own function center, mm-hmm, in Blacktown. So that there also be, I had a Friday night with a buffet, and you see, mm-hmm, and I did Sri Lankan food, like, you know, function.
Yeah.
So then only I really started with the catering. And in 2014, I started my own restaurant in, mm-hmm, June Gary. Mm-hmm. Sri Lanka restaurant.
Yep.
And then 2017, so we opened in Glebe.
Alright.
So Glebe was actually, I want to do something, I want to bring Sri Lankan food to the other community as well.
Yep.
Within Tungari, we were mainly selling,
yep,
Sri Lankan
food. So how did you come up with the authentic, with the food I tried, these are all the street, Sri Lankan street food,
yep,
like the, yes, the egg hopper, then the kottu roti, and the string hoppers. Those are the Sri Lankan street. So how did you come up with this idea that the Australian will actually accept that food over here?
It's actually a challenge as well. And then a lot of people are trying to do fusion.
Yeah.
Like, they will always want to do fusion.
Yeah.
But I believe in my cuisine. Like, I believe in my food. I know it has a good taste.
Yeah.
So I thought maybe, you know, people will accept that. Because some people, there are a lot of people won't try it actually when you're authentic.
Authentic, yeah, that's correct. That's the reason why I actually looked into the what's the authentic food in Sydney, and obviously Sri Lankan one, and your restaurant comes up quite. It's when you go do the Google search, your restaurant will come up.
Well, that's why I thought I took it as a challenge. Actually, it worked well. A lot of people actually really seem to like it. They don't want to have fusion, you know. They like to try. They come here.
Yeah.
You get a real experience of Sri Lankan food.
Yeah.
So that's what they do. We actually did the same spices. Mm-hmm. We have we don't do mild there, like we do the same spices.
Yeah, yeah.
As we do Sri Lankan people.
Now I got the hint.
It's
heat is good. Obviously, it's a kind of like you feel that authenticity of the food. Because if you come out of the degradation of the spices and all, it doesn't make any sense. So no, but you're keeping the standard of the authenticity, so which is great.
Yes, you just come Sri Lankan people come here as well.
Yeah, yeah.
We cater for both and we do the same sort of food.
So how many restaurants you got were here in Glebe?
I had two before, but now I have sold one.
Okay.
Now I only this one.
Just only this
and
one.
I do
okay. Cater. Yep. Yep. So yep. Anything else you want to talk about to the world or the Sydneysiders that?
Yeah, I would tell everybody to come and try the authentic Sri Lankan food if you want to try any authentic.
Yep.
We always try to keep the basic real flavors, and we use our own spices, mm-hmm. we grind our spices, and we use old fashioned ingredients, and we use all traditional methods mm-hmm. to make our food.
Yep.
And we take our travels to give a great food.
Mm-hmm.
I invite everybody to come and experience it.
Yep.
Thank you very much for coming. Yeah?
Also, I'll have to add to that, with obviously the food. The food was really delicious. I mean, like, I enjoyed it probably from the beginning to end. Also, I got to give credit to the staff member as well. When I walked in, I looked at it like they were pretty, very friendly, and they accommodated. And I said, look, I'm going to vlog, so I need a bit of space. And they actually gave me a room as well to, because I need that vlogging area to talk and all this. But they're very friendly, and I actually did the bit of shooting in the on the kitchen area as well. So also the first impression when the customer comes in, the staff actually creates a lot of impression, which I got that one first. Very good impression and very friendly, and they are quite knowledgeable about their food as well. They were describing what they're serving, so which is very good.
Thank you.
And if you want to try the authentic food in Sydney, come on, try over here in the Glebe. I will put a description in the link below, so check it out. And one of the best authentic food I have tried, any ethnic background, I've tried one of the best Sri Lankan food, and very authentic it gets. So come and check it out. And thank you, Manjula, for accommodating me.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you. See ya.
Thank you.
See ya. Take care. Alright, I feel very embarrassed because at the moment I'm trying to pay the bill, and Manjula, the owner, is saying that he doesn't want it, which I don't want any vloggers to get used to with this. Well, thank you, Manjula.
No, thank you very much.
So he gave me the complimentary food, which I don't encourage any vloggers to do it. So, but thank you, Manjula. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye. All right, before I go, thank you very much for all the awesome, delicious food. Thank you very much for accommodating me. Thank you. Well, see us.
Bye.
Oh, well, as you see that the owner did not want to take the payment. I tried to pay. But anyway, thank you for watching my video today, and if you are in Sydney and you want to try the authentic food, place over here the dish, Sri Lankan street food. And please subscribe the video and click the like button if you liked it. I'll see you next time.